This discussion focuses on biosecurity. Biosecurity is a system of management procedures designed to prevent or greatly reduce the risk for introduction of new diseases into a cattle operation. Implementing a biosecurity plan is like purchasing an insurance policy for the health and productivity of the herd. Producers should work with their herd health veterinarian to develop a plan. An effective biosecurity plan should involve the family, employees, the veterinarian, and other specialists as needed. The plan should provide reasonable protocols, which are more likely to be followed to minimize introduction of new diseases. The goal is to prevent disease from ever entering the operation and to minimize the risk of infection if it ever does. New diseases can be introduced to your cattle operation in a number of ways that include water, which would include such things as ponds and pools of standing water which animals may have access to, in addition to stream water where animals upstream could contaminate the water supply and effectively infect your animals. Second is humans and equipment moving between herds or farms. And the third is non-livestock sources such as pets, birds, deer, coyotes, rodents, ticks, and other insects. Not only that, but we could introduce disease by providing contaminated feed, feeds that are contaminated with feces, urines, mold, or ruminant byproducts would be examples. Cattle moving into and out of your operation, okay, particularly the replacements from other herds such as bulls or replacement heifers, or fence line contact with neighbor herds, or cattle that have gone to shows and fairs, or animals that have just strayed onto your property. Another source of disease would be manure on footwear and clothing, tractor and equipment tires, trailers, and processing equipment such as foot trimming tables would be other sources of disease. When introducing new animals to the herd, you should, number one, know the herd status of the herd supplying the replacements or the bulls. Number two, obtain the health vaccination history of new animals. And number three, in some cases, it might be necessary to have your veterinarian speak with their veterinarian regarding the health at the farm of origin. New animals should be isolated and observed for health status daily before introducing them into your herd. New animals should be isolated for a period of 2 to 4 weeks before introducing them into the herd. This includes not using shared feed or water resources and no nose-to-nose contact. Be a diligent observer of cattle for signs of disease. Know the signs for animals that are getting sick, like droopy ears, snotty noses, being lethargic, being lame, animals that stop eating, etc. Also know the signs of important foreign animal diseases, which include blisters around the animal's mouth, nose, teats, or hooves, like foot and mouth disease, or central nervous system disorders, such as staggering and falling, which might be indication of BSE, abortions or abnormal discharges, which might be indicative of some of the venereal diseases. Report any sudden or unexplained death to your veterinarian. Also report to your veterinarian any severe illnesses that are affecting a high percentage or number of animals in your herd. Have your veterinarian necropsy every dead animal unless you are certain of the cause of death. Insist that outside individuals coming onto your farm that they adhere to clean sanitary practices such as clean clothing and footwear, clean equipment, and clean trucks. Minimize non-livestock traffic whenever possible by controlling pets, rodents, and insects. It will not be possible to exclude all wildlife, and you may not want to exclude visitors, but you can take steps to greatly reduce the risk of them introducing a new disease. Another practice is to maintain perimeter fences to prevent mixing your cattle with your neighbor's cattle. Also, disposing of dead animals properly can help control disease. And there may be some local and state regulations that need to be followed. So you need to follow up on those rules and regulations. where animals could be disposed of by rendering, by burial, or by composting. Again, check with the local health authorities to find out what's most appropriate for your area. When disposing of dead animals, make sure to prevent runoff contamination into water resources. For those animals returning from shows and fairs, make sure to keep feed storage areas free of those animals so that contamination of feed resources is eliminated. Do not share equipment with other exhibitors. Change clothing and shoes worn at the fair before working with animals at home. And isolate returning animals from the herd for a minimum of 14 days. Regarding visitors, keep a record of visitors, what dates they were there. Determine if visitors have been on other farms or ranches or shows prior to visiting you. Special care is needed if visitors have recently been in another foreign country. Observe for suspicious individuals or abnormal activities and contact local authorities appropriately. When visitors are allowed on the premises, minimize the number of access routes to your operation. Consider locking or obstructing alternative entry sites. Require that visitors use plastic boots or disinfectant foot baths, and minimize unnecessary direct contact with animals. Place signs describing visitor policies in clear view, and designate parking areas for visitors where it minimizes the cross tracks with feed suppliers and deliveries, and it minimizes visitor and vehicle traffic in livestock and feed areas. Do not contaminate feed with manure. Use separate equipment for feed and manure handling. Make sure that you clean and disinfect any equipment that's used for handling manure and dead animals before handling feed.